It's me here, Pancho Libre. And I am super excited to do this review today. We are doing an action figure review today. Like always, gotta straighten out my mask. And I want to say thank you for subscribing. If you're not subscribed, please hit the subscribe button. Alright. Please give it a thumbs up, a like. And if you want to know more, ring the notification bell and leave a comment down below, and I'll do my best to get back to you guys. Alright, let's get down to the brass tacks. Here we go in 3, 2, 1. Voila. Hello, and today we are reviewing Star Wars Black Series, George Lucas in Stormtrooper disguise. And I also want to tell you guys, we are kind of doing a new setup today. Let me know in the comments below how you like it. Gonna start off with the Star Wars Black Series logo here. A little bio of George Lucas and Stormtrooper armor. George Lucas, the man himself. And if you don't know who George Lucas is, you're either living in a cave or you just untouched with reality. Because he is the man, that created Star Wars. And let me tell you, brilliant idea from the man. Brilliant idea. But let's go back to the card here. It's got George Lucas himself, Stormtrooper, well, Sandtrooper. Got some more bio here. Then you got the 50th Lucasfilms Star Wars thingamabob. You have all the Star Wars movies and maybe shows, it looks like here. Got some more legalese, some stuff in Japanese and Arabic and all that good stuff. Some UPCs, barcode, legalese, Disney, all that good stuff. And as we turn it to the side, you see a nice profile picture of the cardstock. This is cardstock of the packaging style. Turn it over. Here is the other side, a nice glossy window of the man himself. And you turn it to the forward. As you can see, we have the 50th anniversary. Sorry. 50th anniversary. Boom! Got it. Ages 4 and up. Star Wars logo. You see George Lucas in Stormtrooper disguise. And you see a nice card profile here of the Stormtroopers. Of him, you know, in there. And some more legalese and warning, choking hazard. Do not give to children under 3 small parts. Do not put them in your mouth. And you got George Lucas himself. Look at this. Ooh, sexy. I'm joking. Alright, now as you guys know the drill, when I snap my fingers, he will be released out of his packaging. And 3, 2, 1. All right. Here we are. Let's look at this awesome figure. Here we go. With the starting, you know, at the head with the photo reel. It has kind of a glossy tone to it. You know, like he's been sweating underneath that helmet. Which, that's okay. And as you go down, you can see that the shoulder pauldrons or shoulder guards are kind of attached on the inside like a It looks like a butterfly joint here. And this armor here is an overlay. I think it's glued into on top of like a black under like suit type thing. As most of the armor for the stormtroopers are. And you go down, you can see the other parts of the armor, the belt, some more of this awesome white armor here. Beck has the same. Look at all this detail. They didn't have to punch this detail in, but they did. They did put the detail in to, I want to say, like, just to make it look awesome. Because it's the guy who created Star Wars. You know, if, like I said, if you don't know who George Lucas is, you're probably in one of those countries where they've never seen Star Wars. Or you're living in a cave. Anyway, let's start at the feet for the articulation of this review. The foot is pegged into a front-facing pin. And it could go back about that far, goes up, and I think front facing pin for pivot and rocker. Yep, look at that, look at that pivot, look at that rock. Same thing with the other boot, and go up, goes down about that far as we move up. And I understand, because the armor kind of cuts off the whole thing, but it's a guy in armor. You gotta understand that. As you move up, it looks like pinless joints here. Maybe it's a double joint, I want to say, or maybe it's a, no, it's a single, definitely, okay, it's a double joint. Okay, let's bend the knee. Yep, it's definitely a double joint. He can't quite kick his Star Wars making butt, but that's all right. That's all right. Nope, I lied. It's a single joint. I am so sorry, guys. Moving to the other side. Maybe it is a double joint. Okay, comment below if you think it's a double joint or a single joint. Anyway, his other leg can go about that far. Like, see, he can't, because it runs into the back of the armor here. Runs into the back of the armor, so he can't kick his butt. But that's, you know what? For being a, you know, a person in armor, I understand. You can't quite kick your butt in armor. And moving up, there is a upper thigh swivel. Can rotate it in and out. Same thing with the other leg. And the leg can go up. And these tabs here look like they get out of the way, but I wouldn't do that so much because I'd be afraid that it would strain it to the point where it'd break off and goes down. See, like, it gets stuck up that way. There's a fly bugging. goes back about that far, and let's see out, not far out, but like I said, it runs into the armor part up here. It runs into the armor up here. Stupid fly, shoo fly, don't bother me. Alright, it runs into the armor. It can't quite do like the splits, but that's alright. Like I said, it's a person in armor. I get it. Anybody in armor, like, unless they're, you know, trained to do that, most probably can't do the splits. And you move up, there is a waist, it looks like a waist rotation. Mine's kind of stuck. I don't know if it's a waist rotation or not. It looks like it, but you got the belt here, and I'm trying to get it, see if it, maybe if I took some hot water to it, it'll loosen it up. Yeah. And moving up to the chest part. He can crunch forward about that far for the crunch forward. Again, dude in armor. Arc back. Yeah, I would say that'd be pretty good. That's pretty good back. Going up to the arms. Now, as you look, it looks like there's a butterfly joint. So it goes forward. It goes back. Same thing with the other one. Now, my butterfly joints are kind of loose, but you know what? I'm not complaining. Not complaining. And the shoulder armor here, it goes up to get out of the way so it can hit the T-pose. The all-famous T-pose. They move up to get out of the way. Same thing with this one. Move up. They're hooked into the arm underneath the butterfly joint here. As you go up, he can hit the T-pose pretty well. And go down. And upper arms. It looks like there is a upper arm swivel. Yep, upper arm swivel here. Moving to, again, it's a pinless, not double joint, but single joint. He can go up about that far. He can make a V with his arm. Same thing with the other arm. I really like this new look to the figures. It really gives them good motion and movement, and it looks like there is a forward-facing pin on the trigger. Oh, vertical! Yeah, for a trigger finger hand. I like it. It's not a horizontal. It's a horizontal. It's not a vertical. Up and down. Yeah, I like it, and it can go all the way around. Let's see about this one. See, this one is... Yeah, this one is vertical, and the other one's horizontal. I believe so. I could be wrong. I'm probably talking out my Yahoo here. But, yeah, look at that. And move up to the neck here. There is a neck plugged into the chest. It can move around. Go side to side, a little tilt, and a little tilt. Goes forward, about that much. Goes back, and then moving up to the... It looks like there's a dumbbell up in the skull. He can go down, bury his chin, you know, a little bit. But... And then you can look up, not that far, and you go, like you said, and he can look that way, it goes all the way around like the Exorcist. It looks like there's a dumbbell in the skull, as I said before. And as we move on, that is the articulation point of the review. We're moving into the accessories with good old George Lucas here. Standing him up, he comes with a Stormtrooper helmet. Stormtrooper helmet. And it fits on his dome. I did it off camera. I like the detail here. There's a little bit of paint smudge. But that's alright. That's alright. I can see some paint smudges and whatnot inside. And he comes with a Stormtrooper blaster. What Stormtrooper does not have a Stormtrooper blaster? I like the details here. Not a whole lot of paint, but that's what you see with Stormtrooper. Okay, now we are moving on to the size comparison. Move good old Georgie boy out here. I don't know if he likes to be called Georgie Boy, but, you know, that's me. Alrighty then, we're moving into the Fortnite Jazzwares Doggo. and a Fortnite McFarlane Cuddle Team Leader. As you can see, Cuddle Team Leader is towering over George Lucas in Stormtrooper armor. And you got the Jazzwares Fortnite Doggo, which he is shorter than George Lucas. Oh, wait a minute. No, I would say they're the same height here. The McFarlane's run normally 7-inch, technically, as the Black Series runs traditional 6-inch. So, moving these guys, or guy and gal, whatever you want to say, going to the Marvel Legends Loki Series Sylvie. And the Star Wars Black Series TIE Fighter Pilot. Now, you can clearly tell the older model to the newest model. The older model, which I gotta clean because it's dusty, doesn't have really like butterfly joints as a newer model, and doesn't have quite the range, you know, as the newer model. That's okay. Or the newer mold, should I say. The newer molds. Still a good size comparison here. And then you have the Marvel Legends Loki Series Sylvie, who is quite shorter than George Lucas himself. Moving on. And moving to the Todd McFarlane Flashpoint Batman. And my favorite, the Batman Mafex Hush. As we go into this, the Mafex line is, I think, an inch taller than the Star Wars Black Series, and like I said, the McFarlane stuff is 7-inch, so it towers over him, but that's alright. As you can see, this is the lineup here for the size comparison, and again, I forgot the head pool and poop emoji, but it's alright. We'll move on from that, and I'm just going to throw one of my favorite characters back in here, because I'm a big dog fan, Doggo, next to George Lucas here. And I want to say thank you guys. Have a nice night or day, depending where you are. And this ends that review. Bye. We'll be right back.